too. Oh,
okay. Blue, 42.
Younger, keeping catch from my dad was one of the only weapons I knew that I had. Will you start the music? He was very abusive growing up, and he wanted an Iowa boy. My parents wanted an Iowa boy who played football. That was what was going to make them proud. We were at a party, and my dad's friends surrounded me. And I was maybe 9 or 10, and it was like I was looking through a hole or a well, and one of them said, "It's such a waste. It's such a waste of your body, of your God-given talent, that you don't play football." I had already had glitter. And I didn't want to destroy bodies. I didn't want to hit them. I wanted to catch them. I wanted to support them. I wanted to move with them. They were a bunch of Go Hawks, Bud Light drinking, Coors Light drinking, Rolling Rock drinking men. When I decided to leave Iowa, it's because my cornfields were already ashes. And I could stay here and try to salvage those ashes, or I could take them to somewhere else. I could take them to another city and hope that maybe they would take on those. And I found Chicago, and I brought it to the lake that can make you feel weightless at the same time that it can make you feel strong. And that's where I found the queerness that Iowa City really wants. They want to be inclusive and they want to be gay, but it's a different, there's no spaces here that are just for queer people. When I moved back here from Chicago, I got to the gym and I was like, why is nobody having sex in the locker room? That doesn't make any sense to me. Or there's no spaces here, like the beach in Chicago. I can bring my mom and my aunt there during the day, but when the sun falls, it's not their space anymore. They have to leave. You can stay if you want to, but you're gonna see things that you maybe aren't a part of. I love that in a city, that there's a community for me to be there, that it's my space, that it's our space. Space, and I will bring my ashes and I will bring my new self to them.